Hop on the grind with OVERYT,
the man who controls the hype.
It's still hip hop, which is, we just made it our own, you know, added exactly. Our own flavor, dance,
So now, if I may ask, how would you say, how and when would you say the hip hop bug found you?
The hip hop bug found me when I was, how old was I? I think eight, nine or whatever.
That deep, huh?
Because what happened was my mother bought me the album The Score by the Fugees, right? Because the lead single, if you remember, the lead single of that album was Killing Me Softly.
Yeah. So
at my age,
by Lauren.
Yeah. At my age, I thought, I like that song. I didn't know anything about hip hop. I just like that song. So my mom's bought me that tape thinking, huh, here's a nice soul album that my son is going to like. And then I put on the tape and the rest is history. I was like, what is this? And it's been hip hop. It's been hip hop since.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So now, with regards to producing beats, so our show is basically aimed at on the grind rappers, which are rappers trying to make it into the game, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So how would you say is the best way to go about producing beats? Because I know that some producers usually like to start off from samples, but you know, there's a bit of an issue with samples.
Yeah.
So if you're starting it from scratch, how would you advise on the grind producers?
But now, there's nothing wrong with samples. Because hip hop itself was literally
a sample
invented from sampling.
I mean, so, I get it. Like, I really do get it. But for me, it's like, you know what? We always having this conversation of real hip hop and fake hip hop, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's not really a thing. But people would just associate trap music with fake hip hop. For I don't know, for some odd reason, I don't understand why, but some people would associate trap with fake hip hop.
Yeah.
And if you listen to a lot of trap music, right, it usually is sampled from somewhere, and then they just add, you know, those there's a when you produce, like, you have claps and samples and that. There's this element that they're like adding this, like, guys, you know, this it sounds like money or like keys or something like that, and then that's how you get the trap sound.
Okay,
but if you listen to old hip-hop from like your Biggies and your Tupacs, that's like literally raw beats, like raw beats.
Yeah, but then at the same time, they also like did a lot of sampling there.
Yeah,
you know what I mean. Like sample, like let's what Speeka was actually saying.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying. Do you want to like carry on with the
take
conversation?
It,
okay, so with this feature now, we're talking all things wrapped with skill and all that now. So we're basically talking about like not just the music element of it, but like the professional skills that go into like being within the space. So over and above you doing like, you know, producing, voiceover, artistry, how do you like combine all of that into like giving you Speeka, and how do you like keep yourself relevant?
That is a very, very difficult question. Because like I'm very creative, like in general. If you put aside hip hop, I'm just creative. As a kid, I would like draw and stuff. I'd like write stories. So that's just that. It's just that with hip hop, I just found an avenue where I'm able to express my creativity, like in its fullest. Whether it's creating a beat, rapping sometimes, and creating content. And as much as I love this culture, I guess I'm just gonna keep going. You know, because. Once that stops, once the love fades out, then I guess then I'll go there and be a plumber or something.
All right. Can I ask there? As a musician, what would you say is the importance of being just a musician?
Of being just a musician?
No. Like, I get it, as an artist, you're usually like the one in the studio recording and all of that.
Yeah.
So as the artist, what would you say is the importance of being more than just the artist?
If you're an independent artist, it's a good idea to learn everything around what it is you're doing. For example, if you're an MC and you know, you can't record yourself, learn that.
Because
now you have these dope rhymes or whatever, no studio. Now you have to so if you have your own little setup and you can record yourself and you can make your own beats, it's a plus. And like as independent creatives, it's always better to learn as much as you can within the space that you're in, because it gives you one up, and that way you don't need other humans as much. You will need them eventually, but while you're trying to build yourself up, it's best to learn as much as you can so that you can carry yourself to a point where you get to a point where people now approach you and ask, hey man, you're a dope rapper, can I make beats for you? Oh yeah, man, I have a studio, can I record, you know?
Yeah. All right, on that note, man, we're going to be talking all things Puff and Pass featuring Usia Shizzy. Can you tell us about the song?
Yeah, with that joint, I was messing around making beats one day, and I came across, I was bumping E Puff and Pass Cup Round Dash RIP, and then I was like, hey man, how come no one has ever messed around with the sample before? Let me give it a shot.
Yeah.
And then I sampled it, and then the first artist I thought of was Ushezi. I sent it to him. Luckily he liked it, jumped on it, and that's how the joint came about.
All right, man. On that note, man, it is 17 minutes past the hour of 4 p.m. Tsiriblomele u Speeka representing Soweto Msotra, you know, stand up.
Yeah.
And yeah, man, we're about to play Puff and Pass. Let's get it.
More than before anything, I'm a fan of the culture.
Word.
You know, like before being a music producer and all of that, I'm a hip hop head. Like, sure. I will debate you about hip hop for hours on end. You know, so it's just if I'm able to contribute in any way, shape, or form, I'm thankful that I'm able to do that.
Now that's what's up, bro. So can we talk all things Kasie Rap, ne? And like, according to you, man, who were the architects, and can we talk about the current state of it and your role in it right now?
The architects, you know, guys like Zola,
word,
architects, Deep Soweto, architects, Mr. Selvin, definitely.
Yeah.
And Vibapaya. But and then currently, I mean, you find it in the mainstream as well, you know, with artists like Zagwe, Questa, they do Kasie Rap. And then in the underground, for me, that's where it's most prominent, because I guess maybe it's because of most of the artists that I work with are like underground.
Yeah.
Your Chakatolas, your
Abo Massiv. Where's Massiv?
Massiv is still around.
Yeah.
No, it's still around. Still rapping. Yeah, Abo Shezi, you know.
Mm.
So it's still active on the underground. Hopefully, in the next few years or so, we bring it up to where it is supposed to be. But yeah, that's another debate.
It's another conversation and another thing that we need to put on our like hip hop to do list.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying. So now, from your perspective, now, like, King Tue shot down, dog, because now everybody's dope, man. Mm. Within this, you know, underground Kasie Rap. I mean, you mentioned Abo Massiv, bro.
Yeah.
Like, yo, man. Like, when I got introduced to like Soweto hip hop, he was one of the like front liners of this whole Kasie Rap thing. So now, like, what do we need to do, bro, in order to like, you know, come resurface, bro, like surface and actually like, you know, have a home.
What we need to do is to get our house in order, you know, because unfortunately the thing with Kasie Rap is that we beef amongst ourselves, singakafika, you know. So even before reaching the top, we're already dragging each other down. There's absolutely no unity, right? There's no unity, and there's also no level of professionalism. You know, like, we take each other for granted. Small things like, hey dog, we're recording on Friday, come through at 12. Dude rocks up 1:30 now, because I understand. You know, small things like that, like taking ourselves seriously enough to be professionals. Like, oh damn, I got a studio session at 12 with Speaker, then I gotta show up on time. Show up on time, do your thing, boom. Nah, but now cats wanna come through to the studio, it's a party, come through late.
Yeah, so, that's the thing.
Yeah, so the moment we start taking ourselves seriously, that's when the outsiders will start taking us seriously, because I think maybe part of the reason that most of our artists in the underground scene aren't there yet is because we don't carry ourselves with professionalism, you know, rocking up at shows, you know, like Sabshaya, you know. That's where we need to start, man. Like, just carrying ourselves in a professional manner where other people outside the game would take us seriously, you know.
I was actually struggling with that, man, when doing sessions and like even even like these these shows right here, it's the same thing that that you're talking about, man. Professionalism is a big thing, man. Rocking up to a set on time and also like looking the part, bro. That's a very important thing, bro.
Yeah.
And just taking yourself seriously, because now like you're gonna come through late on let's say a Kafula One Must Die, right? Yeah. And then you're gonna hit me up on Monday on some, yo man, can you please play my song?
Yeah.
But then it's like, yo bro, you don't respect me enough to actually you know, come through. But anyways, so look, can we talk about you know, the Sotra Cyphers, you know, like how that started, how many people have you plugged onto that, the following, and like what you're currently doing? Because I saw a young article about like a partnership with you and Mr. Slick or something.
No, with Uzawe.
Oh, Zagwe, yeah. My bad.
So with Sotra Cyphers, I started it in May 2016.
Yeah.
I just quit my 9 to 5, and
post-center vibes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I was basically looking for something to keep me busy within the culture. And this one day I was in studio with, name drop alert, Maseven, Big Zulu, Nubian Queen Masisi, and Zwes Tornado. So they were all recording tracks for my seventh project. So they were all writing in studio, and if you've been in a situation where cats are writing in studio, it gets tedious and boring.
Yeah.
So I was like, okay guys, while you guys are writing, can I just like shoot you guys rapping over my piece or something? And luckily they all agreed, so I shot them, and then the next morning put it together, and I literally came up with the name Sotra Cyphers as I was editing. Like, oh damn, this could be a thing. And then the next day put it up, and the response was dope. I was like, okay, this is the first one, let me do a second one and another one. So in total I've shot like 72 episodes.
Damn.
I've put up how many rappers, I don't know, man. I don't know, man. A lot of rappers. And so this is the fifth year now, 2021. And the cool thing, this coming Monday, the 8th of February. Okay, quick backtrack. I linked up with Uzagwe. And he hit me up on some, because he's got his own KZN Lockdown Cypher going down in KZN.
Oh, wait,
right?
Aren't you talking about the thing that Impact posted on Insta?
Yeah,
Durban.
I didn't see.
There's
a
Durban one, right?
Yeah. Zagwe has his KZN Lockdown Cypher. So he's like, hey man, let's join the two. I'll bring 15 cats from KZN, you bring 15 cats from Gauteng, and then each day I put up one, you put up one. Next day, put up. So yeah, so on Monday the first episode is dropping. That's gonna be amazing. So yeah, check that out. It's gonna be live on my YouTube channel, right, and on Zagwe's profiles, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, all that good stuff.
Yeah, what's your take on that KZN hip hop, bro? Like, man, hey, like,
yo. Listen, me personally, more than anything, the producers.
Yeah,
KZN.
Yo,
KZN. I mean, listen, man. Like, I love Joburg, I love Soweto, I love the Val, but the producers, son, go to KZN.
Yeah.
Peace to MPZ, your K Masters, your XY.
Yo.
MPZ.
MPZ. Listen, yeah.
There's something in the water there at KZN, and I wanna go there and get a sip, you know what I mean?
KZN
has amazing producers, more than anything. And then obviously the cats as well.
Yeah,
man,
caliber of cats.
The caliber of MC. Like they don't mess around, dog. Yeah.
Definitely.
Your Uzagwe, this cat's like
Duncan,
Phoenix, shout out to him. Ah, dog. M squared.
There's something called V Assessor, bro.
Assessor, but I think she reps Mpumalanga. I'm not sure.
And it was speaking of Duncan and Zagwe, man. Yeah. Like I was even saying, Jorge, like that was actually the best project in 2020,
right?
With regards to just bars, bro, and also like storyline, production,
the production,
and also like the way in which that's one thing about Zagwe, man. Yeah. Like I've just been watching him. He's always one to like put everybody on. Put as many people as he, so like for him to put like Assessor on, because we all know that Assessor's been grinding and she just needs Tanya. So yo man, for me, that's respect.
Assessor won best female at 2015 Sahas, I think. So she's on that level. It's just that careers, but it's dope that Abu Zagwe scooped her up, because she definitely deserves to be there.
Now what is poor, man? We're running out of time, bro. Okay, we just got a couple of questions, man. Okay, let's talk about like this era of hip hop, man. Okay, so we basically like to call this like the on the grind era, man.
Yeah.
So what do we need to do to create a sustainable future for us, and where like most of us benefit, bro?
What we need to do, dog, is like I mentioned earlier, keeping that level of professionalism. Mm-hmm. Like if you take yourself seriously, eventually people will start taking you seriously.
Yeah.
And then also it doesn't hurt to have a good team behind you, because I know many examples where this person was grinding like alone, and then once they got a team behind them, then things took off. Mm-hmm. And it's very tricky trying to assemble a team, because you have to find people that are that believe in what you do almost as much as you do. Because right. if you like bring people on that are just I'm just born, you know, it's they're not really in it with you. So if you can manage to be lucky enough to find people who believe in what you do so much that they're willing to sacrifice their time, because people have jobs, people have lives outside this whole music thing. So if you can find people that are willing to sacrifice what they have to help you out, that'll you know, in the long run help them out as well, and have the patience for it as well,
right?
Then run with it, though.
Hey man, don't you think the game needs new leaders though?
Yeah, I mean,
I like to put like your name in the hat for like, you know, like the new leaders of the game.
Yeah, but
hey, I'm tired of this.
But as with everything, I guess, you know, if like like with like for example with like presidencies, after two terms you must chill so a new person can take over.
Right.
So maybe, I don't know, maybe.
Okay, all right. So like as we wrap up now, what's your message of hope to like the upcoming artist / producer / content creator / creative man that's still trying to make it through?
The harsh truth is that, especially in SA hip hop, there aren't many happy endings.
Hmm.
You know, there aren't many happy endings. Not all of us are going to become millionaires.
Yeah.
There's literally probably like five or probably two hip hop millionaires in South Africa. So remember that. So if you're doing this, especially in South Africa, if you are doing this, you have to love it. If you don't love it, dog, go get a job.
Yeah,
if you don't love it, forget it. Because you have to do this, you know, putting in the back of your mind that, okay, sharp, never make cares. But man, I love doing this, and I hope that I find my little niche market, like a few hundred fans that are going to mess with what I do. If I'm lucky, if I'm lucky, then I'll blow up. Because luck has a great deal to do with it. You can be grinding for 15 years, but if you don't have that one instance of luck, then forget. So just know that, brah, the SA hip hop industry, it's rough. It's rough. And if you know that and still want to carry on, that means you love it. And for that, I say, yes, go forth. Yeah. But if you're just like, you're watching MTV one day and you're like, and then you try it once and then it doesn't turn out well, and then you quit, then we say good riddance.
Word.
Yeah. Because if you don't love it, then forget it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Damn. Now that's really powerful, bro. Yeah. Where can we find you on social medias, bro? And like, yeah, plug yourself. What are you doing next? Like, yeah.
Yeah. So yeah, social media everywhere. It's Speeka, RSA, SPWKA, RSA, Insta, Twitter, Facebook, all of that. And yeah, at the moment, still pushing the Sotra Cyphers. And also the KZN Lockdown Cypher meets Sotra Cypher starts on Monday. So just follow us on all the social media platforms at Speeka, RSA, at Zagwe. And then, yeah. That's now, what it is.
Now, word is born, bro. I just want to say thank you for pulling up, man. Like, you don't know how much respect that, like, I personally have for you.
Hey, amen. Thanks
like,
for having me, dog.
Hey, amen.
Thanks for showing up on time.
And yeah, man, like, anything, any new music that you have, man, just know that this is
your home
now. You know, swing it through, and yeah, man, we're going to rip it, man. No diggity dog.
Thank you, Machi. Hip hop on the grind with OVERYT.